session so that in case somebody wants to watch it, then he will be watching it. So are you able to see my screen that I'm presenting? Like, can you put it on chat? Okay, thanks a lot, Pratim. Hey Ayush, you are on mute. I think you should rejoin Ayush in case there is some trouble. Okay, yeah, take your time. And tell me guys how you are doing, what are you doing right now, and how is your preparation going? So which year you are from, first of all? Like, can you put it on chat, like year of graduation, basically like 2021, 2020, 2022, and there are so many like registrations from previous years, so that is the reason I'm asking. So which year you are from? Nice. Yeah, Pradyum, you have written 2019.
Hello.
Yeah, Ayush, you are audible now.
Okay, sorry guys.
Yeah, so like Pradyum, yeah. You have written 2019 to 20. Like, what does it mean? Okay, I'll be graduating 2020. Okay. Yeah, sure. So yeah, Ayush, you are saying something, right?
Yeah. Thank you for introducing me. So myself, Ayush. I'm Ayush Vashne. I'm currently working as member of technical staff in VMware India. So my current profile is not just development. I'm a bit of security engineer as well. My profile is mixed of security and development. So I think there are lots of questions that I have received already, and I'll like to go ahead with answering those questions. And if there is any question that you guys specifically have in between, you can stop me there, and we'll take it from there.
So yeah, so what I thought that let's start with the prerequisites first, so that once we will just start with what are all that we are going to discuss, and we will be discussing those first, and then after that we will be taking forward to question answer, like
okay.
It'll be fine, right? Yeah, because question answer we can take later. Let's say if we have already discussed, then we will not take that question, right?
It will
help us reduce some, like sneak some time.
Yeah.
So the question is campuses visits. So basically, you like you might be aware of what VMware is actually. So VMware is a like cloud-based solution provider. It is one of the leading cloud-based solution provider for various Fortune companies as well as it is also like top 10 Fortune company right now, I guess, right? Like working in VMware is really a like great experience for people working. It is one of the best places to work in. And like mostly, yeah. So let's come to this. While talking about this, we will also tell more about VMware and how we can get into it. So like, what are the campuses it visits? So basically, VMware wants your fundamentals to be very good, and want people to be really engaging into their curriculum and really good with computer science and software engineering and networks and operating systems and all this stuff. Basically, they want you to be your foundations to be good. So that is the reason it goes first to the campuses, like as you can see, like on the screen, IITs, NITs. This is the only company colleges or campuses that it goes,
right.
And also a few more top private colleges. Bits, KIT, VIT, and like I'm not sure other than these come colleges that it goes, but yeah, this is where it goes. It doesn't take any pool. It just goes to those campuses, and if those campuses have few more branches, then they can actually connect with them, or they can call out their other students from those branches, and they do in the same place, right? So this is what they do. Yeah, but it also, like, other than this, there are some exceptions. Few government colleges it also visits. So these are also dependent on the branch of that specific VMware location, basically. So if there is some VMware that is very, there is a college that is very close to the some specific branch, and that they know that these are some good students or good maybe they would be a good employee as well, so they go to those campuses as well. Other than that, they also have some different ways to hire people. That's called off campus. VMware is having thousands of employees right now, basically. What are the number of employees?
It's more than 10,000. Yeah,
it is more than 10,000. So as you can think of, 10,000, we cannot take from just tier one colleges, right? So there are so many colleges and they have from, but they do not go to the campuses. They mostly, first of all, do campus hirings in the beginning. And once they are done with the campus hiring, they got their interns or they got their employees from those campuses. Then they start looking for a few more people who want to join and have enough caliber, or I can say qualification to crack their interview and join them in the team. So this is what they do. So as I said, first of all, they go to the campuses and then they start doing off campuses. They can take applications for off campuses as well. So your work would be to be really prepared, because you are competing with some really top engineering colleges, right? If in case you are looking for off campus drives, if your college already calls VMware, then it is the best opportunity for you, because there will be handful of people that you will be competing with, and there would not be that much of high level of questions. I will be talking about them in a little bit. So the basic idea is you are going to compete with really good people, students basically, if you are a fresher, and it is going to be going to be a tough interview if in sense for the preparation. But once your preparation is good, then interview is going to be really easy, because as I'm coming to that point, interview is going to be really easy if you are already prepared. So yeah, do you have anything to add in this off campus drive thing?
Yeah. I'll take it from there. So guys, one request, I think maybe somebody is not on mute. Maybe
okay. I'm not on mute, sorry.
Okay, no problem. So I'm from KNIT Sultanpur. It's a government college in Uttar Pradesh. So for me, getting into VMware initially as a college hire was very difficult. I mean, I can already tell you that going to VMware and companies like these, product-based companies from tier two colleges, is difficult. But nevertheless, I am a lateral hire, and I think if you have proper guidance, proper knowledge of the stuff they ask, they probably what they demand. If you have that, it's nothing compared to what you can get in IITs. So yeah, so there is an exception with universities where they go. One is Chitkara University. I recently heard about Chitkara University. It is in Punjab, I guess, maybe. So this university and Amrita University. These two universities, they definitely go for campus hiring. Even they can skip for a few of the IITs, but they'll go for these two companies, these two colleges, definitely. Okay. And for on the next slide, we'll go with how off-campus drives can be easy for you. So right now, I'll give you only 3 points for off-campus drives. If the VMware is not coming to your college, so you'll have an eligibility criteria of 70 percentile or 70 percentage or whatever is your college criteria. For in my college, it was percentage. So in most of the colleges, it's percentile or CGPA. So it's 7 and above. And so whatever I'm going to tell you later is in VMware is definitely differing from my team or R&D section. So whatever you will read about VMware, their package, their questionnaire and everything. So that's typically different from product teams and R&D teams. Okay, so so for example, in R&D team, the roles are mixed, means you get opportunity to try hands-on on DevOps, development, machine learning, AI, ML, whatever you can call off, they have all the capacities that they can fill off. But if you are, if they are hiring for a particular team, for example, VMware Horizon or a Nessus project. So what they will do is they'll specifically demand for few of the skills and they want mastery in that skill. It doesn't, I mean that if you know Spring Boot, just you know Spring Boot, they won't hire you, right? You, if you're mentioning Spring Boot, then it should be in a way that you know end-to-end and you can code directly on Coder's Bed or any platform directly. You don't have to see the syntax at all. So that's what they demand if they are hiring for a particular team. But if they are hiring for R&D team, so it's quite open for them. You'll throw that, you know, security, you know, development, you know, in development, you know, Django, you know, whatever language you'll tell, whatever platforms that you'll tell that you have explored. So they'll go ahead and ask questions on that platforms. So that's what you should keep in mind in the sense of VMware. It's always differing from what they offer and what they demand for R&D in India, because in India, the R&D section is quite bigger and it's comparable to US R&D. So here, research and development in VMware, it's in Bangalore office, the size of team and the amount of contribution that we do for VMware in India, it's quite comparable to what they have in Palo Alto, their official front first campus. So they demand a versatile candidate. So that's what. If you are focusing for most of the questions that I read that you guys asked were basically if you have ML projects, if you have this project or that project, so what you should go for other project or not, if you have already done a machine learning projects, you should go for development projects or not, questions like this. So in one line, I'll say if you are looking into a profile in R&D, you definitely should go ahead and try different languages, different platforms, whatever you can see of. Go ahead and see what VMware basically works on. So right now, for example, I'm working with three teams. One is US, one is in Japan, and one is in India. So these three teams, they have different projects and they demand different skills. So somewhere I'm working as a Jira automation engineer. Somewhere I'm working as a security engineer whose responsibility is to track bugs and find bugs and mitigate those bugs. Somewhere other places I'm working just as a Django developer. Right. So if you are versatile, then definitely you should go for R&D in VMware. Else, specializing in one skill would also be helpful. If then you'll have to go with one team. Okay. Yeah, Om. You're on mute, Om. Yeah.
So as I said, that there are so many teams in VMware. So this is one more thing that is a good thing sometimes, and sometimes it is a bad thing. See, like the hiring process in VMware, if it takes off campus, I'm not talking about on campus, because the on campus is very much like they have a curriculum for the on campus. And most of us know that curriculum, like what are the questions they ask, how they reach out to you, how they like what are their interview processes, what are their rounds. But for off campus, there is some, like there would be some surprises, I'm saying. Like it because VMware is like recruitment is based on team. So like the recruitment like manager or whoever is recruiting anybody and taking you to the interviews will be responsible for a specific team, not for whole VMware. And they will be looking for your skills based on that specific team itself. Also, the people who will be interviewing you would be from those teams. So sometimes it is very hard. Let's say if the team members are like asking really hard questions in sense, let's say, and sometimes it is very easy as well. So it also depends on your luck. So if you got into you got to interview into some team where the interviewers were not asking that much hard questions, they were trying to get the fundamentals. And if you have good fundamentals, and if you are passionate about to work, and you are very much in the coding, or you are very much into the into the working of on those tech stacks, then they will definitely like to have you. And they will like it. Also, as I said, it depends on the interviewer so many times because it is based on the team. So like, wish you luck before you actually apply, because it will decide so many things for you. Maybe the percentage whether you will get hired or not will also be a decision maker. So so let's go to the next slide, or I can say next thing that we want to talk about, how to prepare. So as it is a very important question for today, that how to prepare. So we got few questions. So till now, do you have any questions, guys? Till now, as we are moving further, how to prepare, and do you have any question till now? Anyone can unmute themselves and ask, or you can even put it in the chat. Okay, I think there are a few questions. What are the skills for the job interview? Is DS algo? Yeah, I will be talking about that. How much expertise is required for a fresher in a particular skill? Yeah, I will be talking about that, Aminash. Yeah, in the next slide, let's talk about it. Yeah, so how to prepare for VMware. So as you can see in the list, I have mentioned only 3 points. You don't have to vendor a lot. Just be very good in all these 3 points, and you will be able to land to work, the job basically after cracking it. So core subjects, as I said in the beginning as well, they want your fundamentals to be really good. So core subjects, try to focus on core subjects. If you are starting it today, if you are seeing that you have 2 months time, then don't waste time today. Even if you are feeling bored with coding, just start up looking on a book of computer networks. Learn what are those things. Learn operating systems. Learn compiler designs. Go through all the questions that has been asked already in these subjects. These are very important topics and very important things that would be definitely be asked from you. Database as well. Sorry, I didn't add it. So you need to be very good in the fundamentals. So if it is a very good thing as well. If you are preparing for a good company, and if they are not asking from some fundamentals, they are just asking competitive coding, then you will also think that why this company is asking just the competitive program? Am I not that much of quality? Am I not adding any quality to their to the pool, right? So this is very important thing for you, that if a company is asking if you have a good fundamentals, if a company is asking if you know operating systems well, computer networks well, that means that the company is not just trying to put you down in the interview. They are just trying to see if you have zeal to learn. So as a fresher, right? As a fresher, what is the expectation? What should be the expectation? To be having an experience? Not at all. If you are a fresher, it is not expected that you will be having a huge experience working on some tech stack. What is very much expected is that whatever you have learned in the college, right? So basically, what do you learn in the college? You learn the core subjects, right? So whatever you have learned in the college, you are good at it at least. You have spent enough time. You had 3 years before you are sitting in the interviews. Basically, if you are sitting on the fourth year of the college, or the last year of the college, you had 4 years of your college. So if you didn't spend your time learning what were provided or served you on the plate, then how would they they expect you to do well in those tech stacks, right? So that
I think Ohm's network is not Good.
PayPal. These are the companies. Sorry,
Actually, you're breaking up.
I was disconnected a little. Am I audible now?
You can go ahead. Yeah.
So I was saying that it is very important to have a fundamentals good. So as you can see in the first point, I have mentioned core subjects, and that is strong fundamentals. The second thing is, what are the coding problems there? So basically they have three tech rounds. Most of their interviews, they have three tech rounds. First round is like basically they want to know if you have like all these your fundamentals good or not. Then the second or third round depends on your first round. So like in the like also like in the first round, they also ask some basic coding questions so as to know that you have good in coding as well. Like in what are the competitive coding problems they do ask? Like what are the level of the questions they are? They do not ask very hard questions from you. Like they don't want to like put you into the burden of learning, like doing a lot of like those things, as they have already know that you are good in the fundamentals. That means that you could solve the problems, right? So this is one good thing about it. So you don't have to like just put your effort in very hard questions like you do for other companies like Microsoft, Amazon. They are very much focused on hard problems as well. VMware actually tries to get best of out of you. They try to get your approach and how you solving approach. So basically your communication, your thinking over a problem. So that's that you have to solve mostly medium level problems. Almost try to solve all the questions that has been already asked. Like go to the Geeks for Geeks. Part of the tags, like see the VMware tags and try to answer those solve problems. As I think you might got the criteria. Like I think I didn't got anything in the chat until now for these questions. What about Android developer? Like Android. I'm in fifth sem student. I have been learning Android for 3 months. What kind of project should I make? Can you give some examples? Which companies to apply for this position? Yeah, Sachin, I will come to that point about this project. It is a third point actually. I am just coming to that. So yeah, so like some good projects in Zoomie, that is very important. So basically you are trying to like be better than other candidates as well. As you can see that they are hiring people who have good fundamentals. People, right? In your campus, there are so many people who might be just like putting their all of their time in core subjects, all their time to solve tags on Geeks for Geeks. Then how would you come out of them? How would you get selected out of them? So this is one edge for you to be having some good projects in your resume. Do some hackathons. Like do some hackathons and build some projects. Like there are so many ways. If you are a student, there are so many ways to build projects. If you don't have that much capacity, you still can start building small things, learn small things and build small things, and then put it on your resume. Make sure you put the link as well of your project deployed somewhere. Link of your GitHub to the resume. The interviewer knows that this is not just a fake, like some so many people just buy some projects, their friends, or they just like steal few of the projects from GitHub. Don't do that. Like try to build those projects yourself, and have the link of those projects deployed somewhere, uploaded somewhere, and like link in your resume so that it actually gets highlighted. People, like interviewer, knows that you have done some work, right? If you are doing that. What are the projects that are good? So Project Guru was also saying that there are a lot of teams, right? VMware is not limited to any specific technology. As like Sachin was asking, should I add some Android problems or and like absolutely you can add some Android projects. In this, like there are so many companies who are just hiring Android developers as well. You should also look onto that. But you have done some Android work. Put your project in the project section in the way, highlight your like if you have uploaded it on the Play Store, like highlight the link that you have on the Play Store. If you have some like users as well, you can show that my 10 friends are using this application or Malaj is using this application for some specific reason. So this is a must to have if you are doing some project. Basically, is LLD SP asked in the interview? Like, see, basic, if they will ask the basic basic or fundamentals, they will be not much interested in LLT as of now. But yeah, object oriented programming is a must. So you should be knowing what is inheritance, what are the basic things, how to apply them. You should be actually very good on object oriented programming. LLD will take a little more. It will be a, like a application. So I think from freshers or like who when they are going to the campuses, when they are taking on that level, not like that much being asked nowadays. Maybe it will start asking. I don't know. Like Ayush can give more like point on to that.
Yeah. So regarding projects, even Shivakant. Okay, Shivakant even asked. So if you are in final year, I'll probably say there are two scenarios where you can jump into VMware. One is through December hiring. That's basically not for off-campus drives. It's only for on-campus drives. And the other option is in the June hiring. Okay, so in June hiring, all the college grads are given opportunity to fairly participate in online coding competitions and hackathons that is organized by VMware, and that is through referral. Once you are referred and they shortlist your profile, you'll get an opportunity to participate in those hackathons. Okay, so for the projects, coming to the projects, see, what is VMware? VMware is basically a cloud computing company. They basically work on virtualization and cloud computing. So whatever you build, if you can deploy it, so I won't say it start very small. It is a big company, create projects that create impact. By that, what I mean is, Om, can you put yourself on mute, please? Yeah, thanks. Okay, so for example, if you have created a small split pay application, just like open any application in your phone, try creating that application. If you have experience in web, try creating website of it. Try creating app of it if you have a native approach. If you know whatever you know means, since you are in final year, I won't say jump ahead and do something that is out of your scope. Prepare your basics subjects first, and then for the projects, whatever you have done, first thing should be you should be knowing end to end what your project is, and you should be deploying it somewhere. Maybe on Heroku, or you can find ample of things where you can deploy. Maybe you can create an AWS easy to instance and deploy your code. So deployment is definitely needed, because in the interview they will ask, okay, finally anybody can create a project. Okay, you have you can even download projects from GitHub, you can do anything, right? But if you don't know how this these servers internally work, how you can deploy it somewhere, and how you can access it from some port, how you can connect some two different machines all together. There is a front end machine, there is a back end server, how you are connecting it, how the APIs are coordinating between themselves, how you are scaling it. If these are the questions that might come if you know this project, right? Else, everybody is on the same ground. If you have written some code, you have uploaded that code, it definitely matters. But it's a common league now, okay? Because if you have done something extra, definitely you'll get an edge. That's what I'm saying. So since you are in final year, again, I'll mention this part. Even it is a ML project or a development project, whatever project it is, try deploying it and know it end to end, what is happening inside it, right? If you have deployed something on EC2 machine, what goes inside this machine, how a Linux machine works, and how it takes that code, how it builds it, whatever it is. Okay, you can thank you. Yeah, you can definitely go ahead and deploy it. That's what my point is. Because in final year, I won't suggest you go ahead and do something extraordinary, right? Okay, yeah, Om, you can take it from here.
Yeah, that was really like good answer. Like one more question was Ayush, that Mohammed was asking whether LLD, like I have already heard it, you have also replied to him.
Yeah.
But how much does it in the interview? Like how much LLD is required?
Okay. So LLD, what you need in LLD as a fresher is, for example, you have created a project. You have a database. So what is the approach that you use to create the database design? What is the reason that you approach that thing? For example, you say, I created a table. It has four columns. Okay. Name of the table is teacher table. And that table has four columns, name, this, that. Okay. Why you have created, the question would be, even if you explain something smaller, that why this is that I have created it that way, the question would be why you have followed this approach, why not some other approach. So this is the level of low level design questions that would be asked. So whatever project you have done, the low level design questions would be mostly why you have followed some minimalistic approach, why you have used Jenkins to build that project, why not you have done it from directly from a script, you only required a single SSH file and a deployment file, why you went ahead with creating a Jenkins job, right? So that's what I'm saying. Only low level design for freshers matters in the case that if you have created a project that's something very unique. Okay, for example, in my recent times, I had created a project. For that, I was interviewed internally in VMware itself because I had to switch projects between different projects. So they asked me in low level design only, if you have followed this approach, why you have followed this approach, and what makes you believe that this approach would be a good approach? Have you tried any other approach? If not, you have to justify your answers. And if you can make justification, that's it. That's it. I'm telling you, that's it. If you can make justifications that this is the approach that I followed, because I know if I would have followed this approach, that would have created this problem, right? Or you didn't have that much of resources or whatever is the issue. Okay, you just have to make your decisions not suspectful or not at any point of time, not random, instead unique. That why you have created, you have given it a thought. Okay, yeah, that's it for the low level design. I think that would be enough. Any other questions, Om?
Thanks Ayush. Yeah, right now, like, let's think and we will be taking few more questions in the way.
Yeah.
So like development ML projects, as also said, like what kind of projects that you can add in the resume? You can add any kind of project, like whether it is a development project, whether it is a machine learning project. Like it would be really great if you have done some machine learning project with along with some papers on it. Like you have done some research papers or something, then you are going to be given more value over your project, because it is accredited from somewhere, right? Research papers are just like that. You have to get accreditation over that, like you have to get some signature. The second thing is your final year projects is going to make sense here. Like VMware and so many other companies like VMware, which ask you what is your final year project. They were impressed, they want to see your expertise, they want to see if you have done something in the team, even if you have done individually, they want to check if you are doing some projects or not in your college. And the, finally, a project is the best way for them to check it, right? So make sure that you say that, yes, I have done the final year project. If let's say if you're not that good final year project, then you can even, like, it is totally over you. You change or you pivot your discussion in the interview. You start talking about, yes, I have done some projects in final year that was based on few of more of the candidates, but I think I will be discussing more about this project that I have worked on. Other than that, like, this is the machine project that I have done in the internship, and it is actually adding more value to my skills. So I would like to talk. And so, like, interviewers just want to see how much interested you are in the space technology, right? They don't want to, like, just dig you out anything without any reason. They have some purpose, and they would like to know if you have done some projects, and they would like to know how you have done. As Ayush was also saying, they would ask the various trade-offs, why you chose this technology over that, why you are not deploying it, what is the challenge that you have got in the project, why, like, can we use this database, can we use NoSQL database, if you are using NoSQL database, which one would you prefer, why MongoDB, why not DynamoDB, why not something else from you. So, like, these are not sure, but I say that these are the questions could be asked from your projects, and this project really going to make sense, your final project is really going to make sense. So if you have Android applications, front end applications, obviously yes, like guys, there is no like the distinction between front end and back end is no more like that. So like so many times back, front end was not considered as very good projects because they were mostly including CSS and HTML. But nowadays it has gone like longer way. It has been scaled using some frameworks. Now, if you will be using some frameworks, some JavaScript libraries such as React, Angular, or Vue, or like anything related, then you are going to talk about it. Like, you have spent some time learning into that, and they are very much like being asked in the interviews. You are no more like a backend guy and front end guy. You, if you have done some projects, you are going to get places, right? And as I said, Ayush has also worked on React before he has actually applied to VMware. So as you can see, like, he's in VMware, right? So like his project must have gone some good places in the interview, right? Okay, so see, the project ideas we can discuss later, or we can talk about it later. What are the project ideas? This is a one really different discussion. And we have added few of these examples here, but you can go a little more into the Google search and check out what are the different project ideas. You can even put it in the channel that we have created. We are trying to make it more engaging by asking such questions. So if you will be asking, we will try to help you out with some ideas and with some teams as well. So try to ask it there. So So let's go to the next question. Next thing, that what are the important links? Where can I find the resources? So I have the Google search itself. So there is no like out of the box thing here. So just search VMware like interview questions geek for geek, and you will get a tag. You can see the second one is Geeks for Geeks tag as VMware. There are a lot of questions that are being asked in VMware. Just go through, just not go start solving these questions. Just try to be have your fundamentals good first. Don't get like frustrated seeing a lot of questions. Even if you will be solving 300 questions, out of which you have solved 150 or 200 questions that are medium level, that will be enough for you. It is not like you have to just solve all of the questions. Like, these will be enough questions. You can take charge of your, build a streak of 2 months, start from today, solve every day 5 questions like of various levels. Ayush, you want to add something into that?
So that's what these links are definitely helpful. I'll add one thing. If you guys, if somebody of you are interested in security, so VMware has a different channel for security engineers that they that R&D teams hires. So for that, you have to go a little bit higher. You must have networking knowledge. You must have knowledge of inter server communication. You must have done some CTFs. So the mostly people mostly go with INCTF, that's organized by Amrita University. If you guys have, if anybody of you would be participating in INCTF, definitely you'll see that VMware is one of the organizers. They are one of the sponsors. And even if you rank around 15 or 20, definitely you'll directly get an interview call from VMware. So, but getting into first 20 is also typical, right? So even in INCTF, you are given opportunity to do Google search. It's all open, but still, if the capture the flag, the CTFs, they are quite typical. So these interview preparations are definitely, these links are definitely for development profile, but to add on, if somebody is interested in security, so VMware takes security as something that is equivalent to development. They have equal number of security engineers in a team and equal number of development engineers. So both are called as member of technical staff. So if any of the interview experience, you will find that the most of the questions are related to networking, OS related questions, something related to some tools in Kali Linux. So don't worry, those profiles would be specifically for security engineer, so not for a development engineer. So that's what, going through these links, you might find something that is sloppy, that you will find that what is this, what are they asking. So don't worry. So but you have to make sure that in which field that you want to go. If you are in third year, this is the best time. If you are in final year, I'll say whatever you have learned in last 3 years, whatever you have explored, go ahead and only work on those skills only, right? Don't start security from today, because security is something that takes time. Definitely takes time, right? Yeah. Over to you.
Okay, like Ayush, can you put those in chat? Yeah. Here, like I have spoken about, like in case somebody got confused about the abbreviation and the names of those challenges, right? Okay, so like I was saying that I have put, share it with you guys. So these are the important links, like you can check on Glassdoor, like what are the important interview questions that has been asked in VMware member. Check the tag member of technical staff, and also you can go to the Career Cup and check what are the important questions that were asked in VMware. You can go to the various places like LeetCode and InterviewBit. They have so many problems with tags, like tags of which one companies has been asked these questions, has been asking these questions. So go to these like places and start practicing. I will really appreciate if you start practicing in any of these two, because InterviewBit has really good like way of practicing problems. Like they have a kind of gamification kind of stuff that will make you more interested in working on it every day. Like they have some streak that you can maintain, like you have to solve some problems every day to get some specific number of points, let's say 300 points every day. That is very much aggressive kind of like learning experience, and like that is very much aggressive preparations, and you should go for it. You are like freshers. This is expected that you will be doing very hard work to prepare for a company, and if you will show that hard work in the interview, they are gonna get impressed with you. That's what you are going to do. Before, you are like an employee, you are a salesman, right? You have to sell yourself. So how you are going to sell yourself is by your skills, is by your resume, is by your like motivation, that the motivation to work in that company. So this is something that is very important for you. So today, as like Ayush said, As I said that these are the practice platform, and as Aju said that there are two ways to get into VMware in a fresher level. First is through campuses. I think so many of you have already you are from good colleges, like not good, basically tier one colleges, tier two colleges, where VMware comes. So many of you are there in the group, while so many of you don't have that college which calls VMware in the campus. So I would suggest that keep this thing in mind that June is the time, right? If you, it is not coming to your campus, June is the time. You have to build consistency and perseverance to make that thing work. There are a lot of companies that can hire accordingly, right? If you think that if you will be building your skills based on data structures and algorithms, and then you will be having all this basic stuff good, then there are a lot of companies that would like to hire you. It is about VMware. It is about you will be eligible for all of these companies. So just start from today, start building a streak. I will say that a streak is really going to help you. So I think these important things are done. I will be taking more questions from you here, and we have got a lot of good questions in the form as well that we have shared with you. So let me take you through one by one. Off-campus hiring professions start from late May, early June. Yeah, correct. Questions are opportunities for a fresher and kind of preparation required, as I told you already. But Ayush, what is the opportunity for 2020?
Okay,
because they are already graduated. Yeah.
Okay, for 2020 batch, I'll say you are already pass out. If you have got some job, it's well and good. Go ahead and look for opportunities in VMware whenever you'll find an opportunity with 0 to 2 years of experience. Or if there is some opportunity that you find and careers.vmware.com, I'll mention the website even. That's easy to find though. So if you'll find an opportunity, ping me or any of the VMware employee. Right, you'll get a referral, and that will increase your chance to get into VMware. So there are definitely opportunities for 2020 batch, because one of my teammate has recently joined. He's a pass out from Chitkara University, and he has joined around August maybe. He was doing internship in some other college and in some another company from he was hired from the college itself, but he got an opportunity in VMware from referral, and then now he's with us. So for 2020 batch, it's great. There are lots of opportunities coming your way in maybe next 6 months, because their financial year ends in February. Okay, that's an insight that I'll give you. Their financial year ends on 31st January to the initial first 2 weeks of February. So after the financial year has ended, for the complete year, the number of hires are limited. Okay, so they'll put most of the hires, lateral hires, in February itself, late February or in early March. So in the careers portal, you'll find lots of opportunities. You just have to look on that and forward that referral ID to some of the VMware employee. You can forward it to me. I'll forward your resume. That's all about 2020 batch, and for the interview preparation. Okay. So for interview preparation, I'll say you would not be a fresher if you are already working somewhere. For example, in my situation, what happened? I was already working in one of the startup called Work India. So if you are doing an internship, for example, the guy that recently joined in our team, you would be added to a bucket of university hires, where you will have 1 month of internship sort of thing, 1 month of training, and then you'll convert it to full time. If in the other sense, you are already working, you are already full time, you are 2020 batch and you are already full time, then the questions will be definitely mostly on what you are currently doing in that company. Right, you are a front-end developer, you are a back-end developer. Everything would be dependent on what you are currently doing, not mostly on your past college projects. The most of the questions, though it may be 3 months, you might have spent 3 months or 6 months, they'll grill down to what you have done in last 6 months, what you have explored, why you have done it, what are the projects that you have done in the company. So be prepared. So in whatever scenario you are lying, if you are doing an internship, then definitely they'll ask college level questions, that what they ask to recent graduates. Otherwise, what you are doing in your current company. Yeah. So there is a question: for how much duration the internship will last, starting from June? If you are hired from June, it would be only of 30 to 45 days. There is a for first 2 weeks, you'll get a hell lot of trainings from morning 8 to evening 8. You'll have regular sessions and all, and after that, you'll give in a project. So it's all depends on your team. You'll get a team of you'll be part of a team of 3 or 4 guys. The minimum amount of time you'll complete that project. Soon you'll complete the project. You'll be part of the mainstream full-time engineers, right? So it's mostly 45 days, Pranjal, to answer your question. Yeah. Okay, the next question is, I don't have any projects, but I have 2 months internships from FAMS. Oh, that's great. I need to focus more on development, or should I continue DSL group process? Okay. So I guess, Priyam, you might be in final years, right? So in final year, if you have already done an internship in FANG, that's really great. If VMware is coming to your campus, then definitely you'll get help from your seniors, that what are the type of questions that are asked in your college specifically, and the things. But if you'll go for June hiring, so I'll suggest definitely go ahead and show them that what you have done in that 2 months in an extended way. In a way that they'll know that in those 2 months you have done pretty good things, pretty good stuff. You have created an impact on the team, and you are confident on what you have done in those 2 months, right? Those 2 months in FANG would be definitely very knowledgeable for you. So whatever you have gained, show them that what you have gained and what have you done after that. In this 1 year span, you are having after this internship to your June full-time chance that you'll get, definitely don't forget solving DSLGO, because for freshers, DSLGO is like a bar. For the first round, it would be definitely DSLGO problem solving. So without that, nobody will ask. If you have not cleared that round, nobody will ask what is the knowledge of development you have, what are the projects that you have done. So definitely focus on DSLGO, and DSLGO for VMware, I won't say it's hard, as Om has already mentioned. Don't go for hard questions, only solve up to medium level questions. And even if you go for hard questions, just know that you should be knowing the approach that is required to solve the question. For syntaxes, for DSLGO, they won't go for any specific language or something where you are barred, that you should be focusing on this particular language only, and you should be solving with this approach only. It's very open in VMware. You would be given chance to solve any of the question in any way possible, may it be brute force or anything. If it's a hard question, you can even solve it, give them an approach of brute force. They'll grill down that what you want.
Yeah, like I'm basically what I'll add, yeah. That it is not about that not solving hard problem. So if you are going to interview in June, then definitely you should solve hard problems, right? So like it is for 2 months, right? If you have just 2 months, then you should not spend much of time like thinking that why I'm not able to solve this problem, right?
Correct.
So if you will solve easy and if you are able to solve easy and medium level problems, then I'm saying that it is very definitely good for you, that you will be definitely like going to compete with your other colleagues. But yeah, if you have some good time, never like deny to work on hard like problems. These are really important problems that are hard, because they require you to think like out in various ways and to optimize. Correct. Like so, like never get afraid to solve like hard problems. It is just that if you have not that much time, then like you start solving a medium and easy level problem. If you have time, like June is enough time, right? You have 4 or 5, like 6 months time, more than that.
Yeah.
So if you have more than 6 months of the time, then like definitely you should like solve hard problems as well. Okay, like next problem, like next question is will projects related to machine learning domain help? Yeah, we have already answered, Ayush. I add more development related projects to my resume rather than machine learning project? You can add, like if you have added two types of like stacks, but that will require extra effort. So like it is totally over you. Like if you have one machine learning project, two machine learning project, and that are really good, I will take time to tell you that two projects are enough. If you have two projects in your resume, that are enough, and that you should know like completely. As Ayush was saying, that they ask from projects, so you should very much know what are the technology that you have used, why not you have used some specific technologies, various trade-offs. So these questions has been already been answered. How to prepare for coding interviews? Divya, I have already shared you that we should start practicing on LeetCode and all this stuff. You should go for the tags on Geeks for Geeks and LeetCode. There are a lot of questions available, but first start from solving easy level problems, maintain a streak, and then go for it, right?
Correct.
What profiles do you look for in a fresher? A great problem solver or a person who has built things? What would you answer?
Okay. Yeah, so for example, I was interviewing this guy recently who has joined our team, Ankit. Okay. So he has done good projects, very good projects. Even on servlets, he has solved so many of the issues. He has a good open source profile, etc., etc. So what you can make out of a person from seeing his resume is you cannot say if you have done some good projects, you can be a good problem solver, right? A problem solving skill is something that comes once you learn about that guy or that person in a long run. For example, right now he's working with me. Now I know him better, that what is his problem solving skills. So what will I say is there are few of the points that all the interviewers judge you on. For example, go ahead, you have created a project. Okay. So they'll ask problems that they might have faced in their life, experience. Okay, if you can give them a solution that you can solve this problem this way, you are a good problem solver. That's it. So in those 2 hours, you just have to find solution for the things. So a great problem solver cannot be a guy who can solve all the problems. Like there is no one who can solve all the problems, right? So again, I'll repeat. You should be having good projects, and you should be knowing what are the problems that you will encounter in that project at least, and how you will solve that problems. That's it. From a fresher, nothing more than that is expected. That's it.
Okay, like one question that I came across by Pranjal, right? Is like if he is very good in full stack but a little bit weak in DSA, so how should he approach for VMware interviews or any interviews? Basically, should he focus more on DSA now?
Right. So I'll definitely say DSA. Where you stand. The first point is, where do you stand? If I know many of the guys who think they cannot solve hard level of problems, and they say, I'm not a good problem solver, I don't know DSL Go. So if you stand in that kind of lane, I'll say stop right there. Go ahead and solve the questions that you find on Geeks for Geeks or any of the platform that are tagged with VMware. If you can solve those problems, that's enough. Go ahead and refine your DSL Go skills. But if you cannot solve those problems, I'll say definitely it's high time that you should go ahead and solve DSL Go problems. You can take any platform, you'll have ample of resources, etc. But you should definitely go ahead and do DSL Go, because that would be the first round. And no matter how much projects, how many projects you have done, how better you have solved those problems, but you must qualify the first round. That's it.
Yeah, like if you can show only your projects, you can show only your tech skills when you will go to that interview round, right? The first round is always like you have to go to the gate, open the gate first before you go to the next, like next room or something. So DSA is the gate here, basically. Okay, like the I have shared one link where I have shared, like I have one guy from Co-Founders Town asked me to write a really good blog, like about these things, that how to start preparing. So you can go through this blog I have written, and you can like start looking from the like roadmap how to follow. Okay, next question I will take that what campuses is it going to have from? Is it really going higher off campus or is it pool drive? No, it is not pool drive, but it little. But if it is off campus, it will take from referrals, as Ayush has already answered it.
Right.
Campuses we have already told you about. In what aspect should we shine the most? Because there are a lot of things we need to get correct to get placed. So we have already talked about it, Hemant. So please, like I think you your answer has been answered. So are you there in the call, Hemant? Can you like respond in the chat, Hemant? I think. Should I go for OSCP to get advantage in social security?
Definitely. If you have interest in security, go ahead with any of the certification. OSCP is much better. Even CEH is something that can make you stand out of your way. But certifications, I'll repeat, certifications definitely show you what you are, but they doesn't define you, right? They would be asking questions, but so they would be grilling down. They will be giving you a CTF kind of hackathon. And if you are not able to solve those questions, you are not able to capture the flag, then those certifications are of no use. Yeah, so I'll preferably say don't spend money much on OSCP. If you are thinking OSCP or any of the certification is a way around to get inside any security company, VMware or any other company, go ahead and get knowledge of that certification. That's the primary thing. And without any help, if you can solve the all the mockups of that certifications, then definitely go ahead and spend that much of money, because these certifications are so costly. Yeah.
Next question is, what are the tech stack generally preferred if someone is seeking for an internship for a role of SDE?
Okay.
So that we have already answered that it is tech stack is very much related to a company. Okay, if you are seeing it very in a general way, that it is very much related to Pranjal's. It is Pranjal's question itself. That it is very much general to like specific to a company. But most of the companies, let's say, who are good enough, they do not like check what are the tech stack. They just basically want to see what have you worked on, right? So it doesn't really matter. But if it is, it will be good if you have some programming skills very well, and if you have done projects on like front end like front end technologies, right, like React.js and Angular.js and Vue.js and anything that is a front end framework, and if jQueries and like basic of JavaScript you have done, if you are applying for a front end role. And if you are just generally trying to add some like some projects, then work on full stack, I will suggest. So full stack will give you more edge over all these technologies and have a say over why you want to choose one over the other. Okay. So the next question is, I am from Tier 3 college. I applied to many companies, but like resume is getting rejected. So what special should I do in coming months so that my resume will get selected for at least for VMware? So like Ayush, can you answer this question?
Okay. Let me give you my experience. I applied in December last year. Okay. I was not shortlisted at that time. I don't know why. I got a call around in April that we have your resume.
You have already told about it. Like I think that's why.
Yeah. So if you are not selected this time, maybe update your resume, give them something new every time you apply, because HRs does not definitely go ahead and see everybody's resume. these points are maybe a greater point of discussion, because they in VMware or any product based company, they have their internal tools from which they scan the whole resume and they catch the keywords what they require. So if you are not selected now, maybe the reason is they are not hiring for the skills that you have. It's not that you your skills are wrong or something like that. It can be the possibility that maybe they already had that much number of candidates they already have, and the skills that you have are not required. So for that position, so don't lose heart. Just update your resume every time you learn something else, and update it to VMware itself.
Yeah, one more thing I will tell you guys, that if you are making a resume, then make sure that your resume is getting like your resume is parsable. Basically, they use some engines, so resume parser engine, some like software to get all the important keywords. So don't make the resumes which would not be able to give what they want. So basically, what I'm trying to say, that if you are making some resume, get some help from seniors who are already there or who have a good say over it. Review your resumes and then only you submit your resume. Resume is very important, right? You have spent your 4 to 5 years, right? And it is going nowadays, if you see, it is very important. If you want a job, you should have a good resume. So make sure that your resume have those keywords and it is getting very really passed from the resume parser of those companies, because they are actually, as I said, that they passed more important keywords and then they reached out accordingly, right? So it is very important. Next question is how the hiring process is done, like the level of aptitude question. So aptitude is not that much, but you should be good in, as I said, the core subject and all this stuff. Minimum cutoff to clear the test. This all depends on your college. That if your campus has a lot of students, then they will be having a good cutoff. They will, for the second round, they mostly want 40 people. Like I have seen so many reviews and so many people I have asked, so many students I have told talked about in campuses, and I got to know that mostly they want to take 40 people in the second round, and they end up with 4 to 5 people out of whole campus in even in the first year colleges. So you can see that what is their expectations. So out of all the applications, they are just hiring 4 to 5 people in the first year college. So you should have a good skill. Okay, when will the hiring process of VMware start? Basically December in the campuses, and June or something around. Just keep on checking it, keep on hustling around. How much VMware focus on projects? We have already talked about it. How to make a resume that got through the company? We have already talked about it, that make a resume don't make a cartoon kind of thing, or don't add some diagram, don't add images. These things really don't work. Your picture in the resume will not work. Your date of birth will not work. Your current home permanent address will not work. Your so many hobbies internet surfing will not work. So just take it out from your resume. Just put all those important keywords that you want a recruiter to see on you, right? Don't put anything else. I have seen so many people who are doing marketing for some companies, basically campus ambassadors. They do not work. I will just suggest you to put only important tech things if you are looking for a job in tech. Don't put that I have been I took the job of a sponsor. I was just the organizer a lot. Organizing things are really good. Put it into your achievements in a single line. Don't put it into a big section that what are my achievements, and then a big section where there should be a project, not how you organize an event, right? Or how you volunteered an event. It will be coming, but it should come into a single line or single three keywords: volunteered this event. Just it. So that people know that you are not you also want to explore so many things. But that will not actually work in a tech job. in the tech job, they want you to mostly mostly doing tech all the time. Like, see, this is how the competition is. It is a reality. You are good at something. You are good at leadership, organizing, marketing, all this stuff. You are good at it. But the reality is that there are a lot of competitions, right? Like this is not something that you should be you should be bad at. You should always be good at leadership. You should be good at speaking. You should be good at everything else. But the competition demands you to be good in technologies. The competition demands you to be good in cloud, in machine learning, in development, whatever you are doing in DSA. So this how the industry is going, you have to be prepared enough, right, for that. And your resume should reflect on that. Make priority list. What are the priorities that you want to show? Like, we will be taking one resume around, maybe sometimes. So resume session where we will try to say how to create a good resume. Like, if you are interested, just keep us on, like, keep us reminded in the group, so that we are also very much lazy and working in our own jobs. So we do not get enough time to spend a lot of time do these things, right? So like, if you will be pushing us to do, we will definitely try to help. Ayush is also in the group, so you can ask any question. He will be happy to answer.
Right.
How to get good at coding? Practicing daily does not help much in contest. How is not practicing daily helping? DM me or Ayush, or you should also put your question in the group that how you are practicing it. You might not be practicing it well, or you might have some headache or some frustration out of it because you are not getting a job. So just think that, just keep on doing work. Like, don't think what is the response I will get. Keep on applying. If you are thinking that I want to apply, keep on applying, keep on asking for referrals. One day you will get a job. See, I have a story. Yesterday, one girl DM'd me, okay, on LinkedIn. She was saying that, hey, Om, I got a job. I just wanted to tell you that I got a job. So I was really happy that she got a job, because then she said that I kept on checking with you so many times and asking for referral in Hastin and other company, but because there was not opportunity there till the time, you were not able to give me the referral. But because I kept on asking you, it was really important for me to tell you that I got a job, and you don't need to think about it anymore for me right now. So it is something that you need to know, right? You have to keep on checking with people. You have to keep on following up people that, hey, I want to apply for this company. If he is not responding on LinkedIn, just again make a message. They do forget, right? They do forget things. Like, people do not reply messages for some time and then think that I will be replying after lunch or after dinner, and then they forget. Who actually stays awake after dinner? Most of the people get on the bed, right? So just try to follow up people on LinkedIn. If you want a referral, don't just go asking questions that are available on Google, because you can see that there are so many people who don't want to get, recently I saw a post, people were saying that they get a lot of silly questions. Don't ask silly questions directly. First of all, ask it on Google. Google is very much helpful right now. Okay. Okay, sorry. So let's go to the next question. Okay, a proper roadmap for final year students to crack a decent product based company like Amazon, VMware, next 4 to 5 years. Okay, Sweta, I have shared you one link of where I have told about how to apply for a job, fresher, post-COVID world. You can check onto that. We have already discussed a lot of things here. So we are just moving forward to what we have not actually answered. A proper roadmap, I will also try to share with you guys. Currently, I have not prepared it. And proper roadmap is simply you have to prepare for DSA. Then you have to prepare for good competitive questions based on that specific company tag. This should be the second step, and the third step should be to to have some projects in your resume, and then the fourth step should be to reach out to the people and ask for referrals. This is only the fourth step, and roadmap is all around that. Just make sure that you are doing good in these things, and if you need any help, just keep on pinging people. Okay, which platform should be focused on for solving practicing DSA questions for the interviews? LeetCode or InterviewBeat? Both are good. Both are really good. I think LeetCode has a lot of questions. InterviewBeat has a curated very important questions. So I will suggest you to go to interview bit. There are so many like marketing banners as well. So don't distract so many times. Just think that you are working, you are on mission for a mission, and you have to maintain a streak and go solve problems from interview bit. If you need any assistance, keep on checking with us. If lead code, then how many questions should be solved topic wise? Yeah, so like I will suggest that topic wise, if you are solving problems, then it is really good. You should start with arrays and start solving at least 20 problems of easy level, and then 10 problems of medium level. 30 problems from each topic is really important, 30 to 40 questions. At least try to solve 5 problems hard, 4 to 5 from every topic or every data structure. They are really going to give you help you with solving other problems as well. These are important. Like I will be like suggesting you to minimum like solve 300 questions. Like I have seen people who actually goes beyond these 300 problems. They are really good and like they get the offer so many times and able to interview. Yeah. Ayush, you were saying something.
No. Actually, Prateek has asked that how should we prepare for security job interviews? So, and how is it different from developer interview? So that's what I have listed down, all the skills that are mostly required for security, that what VMware asks for. And definitely security interviews and development reviews are way different. You maybe for the first round also you'll not get DSLGO problems. You'll directly go for a CTF, and then after that your interview will start. So security interview is completely different from development interviews. That's what my point is. And your projects for security interview, I like to mention, you must have something, an achievement in CTF, or an achievement where you have done some open source vulnerability finding issues, or you have done some ethical hacking or something like that. That would be a way beyond good for your profile. So for security, that's a different league. We can even go into detail on our Slack group. Okay, yeah, Om, go ahead.
Yeah, like I think the next question, like have we solved the answer, like answered the question, like Kushar, like I think
we have solved.
Thanks, man. Okay, like apart from DS and algo, what are the fields we need to explore, like open source? Yeah, you should explore cloud. Yeah, exactly. like there are a lot of things like google I'm saying, like GitHub developer pack gives a lot of free resources for students to explore cloud and other development stacks. Like go for it, like apply for GitHub student pack. They include everything like Heroku, Google developer, as well as like so many things like DigitalOcean and all this stuff. Like you should go for, man. Like open source, it is very important nowadays. It is getting more important every day. Any more questions? If you have, like, if we have missed any of your problem questions, right, just put it on here. We will try to wrap it up as soon as possible, so that, because it is already 1.5 hours. Does the busy GitHub profile make an impact in the interviews? What will be your view, like Ayush here?
Okay, so with busy profile, you might want to say that you might have good green dots over your GitHub chat. So I'll say that's a good symbol, but creating an impact would definitely create an impact on interview, right? But there, I don't want to mention this thing. There are scripts through which you can create green dots that nobody should do. Because that's what is hampering our community, is hampering our developers community, and that is creating a wrong impact. People through scripts are creating green dots on their profile, and they have only 2-3 projects. But it's you can cheat. There is a code that I'll remember. You can fool many of the people many of the times, but not all of the people all of the time, right? you will be caught somewhere. So having a good profile, if you have done some work, then definitely it's very good. It will create an impact. But just for creating impact, don't go ahead and create green dots over there. Yeah. Do you have any suggestions, courses related to AppSec? Currently, I'm doing bug bounty enter course from Hackers. Oh, that's great, Pratik. I'll say if you're doing a bug bounty course, complete it and go ahead with CEH. And if you're not willing to spend much of the money on CEH, go ahead and solve the mockups. Complete the course wherever you will find. You'll find ample of code on Udemy, and there are many resources. If you guys won't find, let me know. I'll also share.
Okay, like Pranjal, one question you asked, that the green dots thing, right? So I will answer this, that if you are doing DSA every day and you want, like, the streak that you will be maintaining on a platform, that is good. And if you want to keep green dots, then why not you like create a repository where you are actually pushing all the like problems that you are solving every day, and then maintain a green dot, right? It is also something that you are contributing every day, like, and pushing it on like correct. So you are already doing that. This is really good. So like if you are doing a DSA as well and you are solving some problems, then push it on every day. It will not just show that you are doing DSA. It will also show that you are good at GitHub, right? And GitHub should actually be a basic, like GitHub is the ABCD. Like so many companies actually laugh when you put GitHub or Git on like resume, because they think that why somebody like who is applying for literature is adding that I have learned ABCD. So like Git is very important. It is critical for you. So like Git is something that every one should know. And it is not something that you need to show it on resume. But if you know, like you should show, like the competition is like that, people don't know, right? So the competition in this competition right now, that so many people don't know Git, and then you will put, maybe it will add some extra advantage. But overall, a good company doesn't want to put this on a like more attraction or more focus on it, right? Because they know that you should at least know GitHub. Like GitHub is a very basic thing. So if you are doing everything on GitHub, pushing your code every day on GitHub, this is a good way as well to contribute every day. Okay. So I think we have answered most of the questions. I'm maintaining a streak of 301 days of code. Great, Pranjal. This is really going to help you in a long run. So, okay. Like, maintain a streak, guys. Everyone should maintain a streak, guys. Can we put ongoing projects in resume? Yeah, obviously.
Yes.
Like I think if you have done something already, see resume, if you will be adding some projects in the resume, the recruiter will be asking you the questions. And if you will be saying that I'm still doing this, then it is not going to give a good way. So just make sure that in the ongoing projects, just add those features that you have added, right?
Correct. Exactly.
If your project is really big, then you can add. Okay. So guys, like we will try to wrap it up, as soon as possible. And the last thing that we are going to tell you is that we are also thinking that if you guys need some help, we can do some like it is some totally based on our community. We are not trying to do much of the marketing or advertisement over this. If you want, we can actually start with some DSA things that if you are getting stuck, right? So we will try to do some sessions or some problems every week. We will be teaching you a few things if you need help. So, and also I have a guy from who is working in Google as a cloud engineer. Okay. So he will be helping you with DSA problems. If you really want this, I can ask him to do. He will really help you guys, I think, because he's very good at it. He can help you. Ayush can also help you with all this stuff. Ayush is good in development as well. There are a lot of people who is already there in the group that we have actually, and they can help you a lot. Make sure that you keep on asking for things, because without asking, we are also very lazy and we just want to do as much thing as is getting pushed to us. So because this is something that we are not getting paid for, right? So if you are not getting paid for something, then why would you do? Only if this is making a difference, right? if we will help you and it is making a difference, then only we will. If you need something, then only we can help, right? So this is something that I want to say. So keep on checking with us, keep on pinging few things important, and also keep on doing whatever you're doing and giving us update in the group or to us personally as well. It will help everyone. If you have no questions, we can wrap it up. I'm really thankful for Ayush to join us and giving very much insight about how to prepare for VMware, and it was really helpful. Ayush, thanks a lot.
Thank you so much for asking me to join. Really,
yeah. I think you have made it a really made so many questions clear, so many doubts you have made a clear, and by giving some referrals as well, you can help few of them if they are good enough.
Make sure that
if you have a good resume, then only ping. If you have a good skill, then only ping. Don't just spam. Because he will also not be able to pass your resume if he sees that your resume is not worthy enough, right? So my college is providing CEH certificate training and certification for under 30K. Is it worth to apply? CEH, what is this?
Certified Ethical Hacking.
Okay.
I won't say you should go ahead and do it with 30K. Why I'm adding money? Because there are lots of institutes maybe they would be. I don't know what institute you are asking about, but if you really want to learn, you'll get ample of resources online, and for certification, you can apply it yourself also. So what these colleges, what these companies do is, even I was once a trap of these training institutes. So they'll provide you CEH in their own name. They'll say that our institute is licensed with the official CEH community. So whatever certificate we'll give would be counted as CEH certificate. So that's just a piece of paper. Even I can give you one. I can print it one for you. So the most important part is learning knowledge. So I'll say go ahead for some courses on Udemy or wherever you'll find. If you don't find something, go ahead and ping me anytime. I'll share a few of the good CES trainings. So again, knowledge is important, and for referrals, as Om was saying, just don't shoot resumes to anyone, not even to me, just because you have seen some profile. Go ahead and look into the profile, check if the requirements that they have mentioned are the requirements that are there, are your skills, are your primary skills. Okay, because sometimes in VMware also, this is the thing, if I have referred someone 4 to 5 times, okay, in lifetime with same email ID and contact number, I have referred someone more than 4 times, and I was not shortlisted any of the time, then that guy might get blacklisted. So in the future, the reason would be either he's not suitable for the job that I have applied, or the skills are not satisfied, right? Your skills are something that are, you require more knowledge, you require more exposure. So even after 4 times, the company would stop looking into your profile and then they'll block you. So definitely take it into account. Just because you have seen some openings, do not go ahead and shoot resumes. Because for me, it's easy. For anybody, it's easy. I'll take your resume, I'll push it to the HR, to our portal. But definitely, because it's taking their time, it's not taking my time much. They'll go ahead and look into your resume because I have referred somebody. And if their time is wasted, definitely some steps would be taken. So my point is clear.
Correct. So thanks a lot. I think it has answered questions about resume and referrals. So make sure that your resume has those skills before applying to that job.
Correct.
Thanks a lot, Ayush. I think we are going to stop recording and closing it. So if you have any question, just keep